Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today's video we are going to see how to make your own vegetation bed at home. We did it from scratch, like the wooden blocks you see, everything we have done from scratch. So in this video I'm going to show how we are going to make the wooden blocks and then how to put the sand, what kind of sand we are going to use, what is the manure we are going to use, so and what seeds we can harvest. Okay, let's get on to the video. So the first thing is the base, the wooden block which I'm showing. The size we used is 4 cross 4 square feet. So all sides it's 4, so it's a square. You can actually buy ready-made frames like this from online or in Home Depot or Lowe's. But the problem is it cost you around, like one frame itself cost you around $60. But when we buy our own and start doing from scratch, it would cost only like all three frames, it was like only $60 for us. So it's that much cheap when you do it on your own. So when you buy wood for this, look out for lumber wood. And what we did is we bought 8 inches and then cut into 4 inches each. So 1 8 inch was cut into 2 4 inches. So if you are going to make one frame, you would need 2 8 inches, and then you can cut it into 4 4 inches and make it as a square, and then small pieces of wood like 2 inches wood to join all the 4 frames. Now you can see my husband is cutting the 2 inches frame. So this 2 inches frame is going to help you to screw the all the 4 inches woods together. This is a screw we used. You can see that it's called Deckmate screw. It was very sturdy and it was very easy to screw to. So this is how my husband did. He cut into separate blocks and then he screwed together using those small 2 inches boards. It's pretty easy. It took like half a day, that's all. You just have to measure properly and then you can screw in. You need proper equipments too. I will give the links down. So here we are. We made the frames and then we set it on the grass. So now what we are doing is we are clearing the area where we are going to do the vegetation bed. So whatever grass it was there previously, my husband is cutting it out. I will give the link of this tool too down. You can use it. If you are owning a house, definitely that tool will be helpful. Okay, now the area is clear. We have removed all the grass. So on top of this, what we are going to lay out is a propellen cloth. It is a weed barrier. So basically if you lay out this cloth and then put sand on that, your plants will grow without any weeds. So that is our idea. We bought a big roll and then cut it into pieces as needed for each bed. You can see now we are doing that. So you have to lay out firmly under the frame so that it stays in place. We cut into two cloths for each frame so that we maximum avoid the weeds as much as we can. So that is what we are doing now. So after this, you can put your soil on this. So this is the first step. Now our frames are ready. So you can see now the soil which I am going to put in the vegetation bed. So we use two things. One is garden soil and another is the manure. So both we made sure it was organic, because at least we could grow vegetables in our home which are fertilizer free, right? So we bought like organic garden soil. You can see the picture here. We got this from Home Depot. The next one I'm going to show is the manure, the cow dung. It's basically cow dung. It is dried and packed as manure. This manure we got from Lowe's. So soil is from Home Depot and manure is from Lowe's. This particular brand is really good. So we went to 2 different stores and bought this. Okay, now let's mix. So I'm going to tell you what is the portion needed for each frame. So ours is a 4 cross 4 square feet, right? So one frame needed around 8 cubic feet of soil. So what we did is we mixed 3 bags of garden soil and 2 bags of manure. So this manure is 1 cubic feet. So one bag was 1 cubic feet. So we mixed 2 cubic feet of manure. And the garden soil was 1 bag is 2 cubic feet. So 3 bags equals to 6 cubic feet. So 6 cubic feet garden soil and 2 cubic feet manure. So total is 8, right? So 8 cubic feet of soil we mixed in each frame. So that was pretty much correct level. If you are going to fill more than that, it's your wish. You can just fill like 1 cubic feet more, but that's how much it fits for one frame. For a 4x4 square feet frame, this is the level. So one thing you have to make sure is mix well the garden soil and the cow manure, so that the manure is get mixed well with the whole soil. If not, your plants will not grow well. So make sure you mix it very well. The rake which my husband is using now was very, very useful when we were mixing it. I will give the link of that one to Vineet. So now my husband is sprinkling water. So before you plant the seeds, you have to make sure the soil is moist, little moist, not like fully soaked. Now I am going to show the seeds which I am going to plant. So I have spinach here, green onion, eggplant, cherry tomato, and then cilantro, mint, and then okra. So if you see these plants, there will be the instructions behind the packet. All these are organic seeds only, and they have given like how much big they will grow and how much space is needed between each plant, and the days to germinate and the days to harvest. So you note this one, and according to that you plant, and depending on the state where you are living, you can start your planting accordingly. This one you see is a twined rope. So this rope, what I'm going to do is my husband is going to make partitions with this rope. So with this rope, if you make partition, you will know like, okay, you planted a tomato here, you planted eggplant here, like that. Now you can see there is some fun part too when we are doing this. The kids are enjoying with the spraying water. Yes friends, actually it took like one whole day, I would say, not like one whole day, like 3/4 of the day. The whole job took us like one day. The kids also had fun. Instead of sitting and watching TV or mobile, they helped us and they also had fun. So this is what I was saying. My husband is tying rope, right? So he's screwing in the ropes to make partition for each bed, so that I could plant like 2 vegetables or 4 vegetables in each bed. This was very useful. After planting the seeds, I was able to identify, okay, I planted tomato here, I planted okra here. So yeah, tying this rope made the job little bit easier. You can try this one too, or you can just keep a point like, okay, I made a note like this year, this area I planted this seed. Okay, now I'm going to tell you what seeds I'm going to plant in which bed. So tomato and eggplant usually grow very big, friends. So make sure you have half of the bed at least for tomato and another half for eggplant. Similarly, okra too. Okra too occupies a lot of space. Other than that, cilantro, mint, green onion, spinach, all these are going to occupy only less space. So plant accordingly. Plan your vegetation bed and then start planting the seeds. And when you're planting, make sure you put a hole in the finger, with the finger, and then you plant the seeds inside that, cover that. Now you can see I'm measuring space between each plant. This is very important, because when you plant seeds side by side, then it will not get proper nutrition from the soil and then the plants will not grow well. So make sure you have enough space between each plant. And another point is, plant only 2 seeds maximum in each hole, because every seed is going to become like a plant. So one packet will have like more than 30 seeds, I would say. So don't dump all the seeds into the soil. It will not allow the plant to grow well. So make sure you measure the seeds and plant properly. This I'm doing this for cilantro and mint. So they were very tiny seeds, so just I sprinkle them. But when you take a tomato plant or a okra plant, you have to make sure you just planted 2 seeds in each hole, because it's going to grow as a big plant, right? So make sure you do that. Otherwise, for small plants, you can just sprinkle like this. It doesn't hurt much. It's going to grow as a small plant only. So this is how we are planting seeds, you can see. So there might be a lot of seeds, but make sure you use only some. You can actually retain some for the next year, right? It's not going to go waste, so you can put it in a ziplock and make it save it for the next year. Now we have planted all the seeds, and now we have turned on the sprinkler. Sprinkler is like a water irrigation system. Many people in US would have known it already. If you are new to US, you are from India, this might be new for you. This sprinkler will be, there will be sprinklers underground, and then once you on it, the water irrigation system will on and it will sprinkle water all over. So yeah, like after 1 week I could see some plants. I was very very excited, so I made sure I captured this. Sorry, I was not able to record it properly. You can see my shadow, but I was very excited to see the plants. So plants are like babies, right? When you plant them and when you see as plants, you feel so excited. And it's good to, instead of buying vegetables from store, we can plant our own and harvest our own vegetables, and it's good for health too. Okay friends, make sure you subscribe my channel because I'll be posting more videos like this. Happy gardening. Bye.